Okay, so Webflow just released a new AI website builder and I just had to check it out. I wanted to see if this is actually worth your time or just another AI disappointment. But I spent the last couple hours testing it and I've got to say, I'm conflicted. So in this video, we're gonna build a real business website from scratch and see if it actually works. And at the end, I give you my honest assessment if this is actually a useful tool. And so let's get started and find out. Okay, so how do you actually start and create a website with Webflow AI? First thing we're gonna do is head into Webflow here. This is just a normal dashboard. And here on the top right corner, we have the new site where we can create a new site. And once we click that, we see that there's one new option that's right now in beta, the AI site builder. So we're just gonna click that. And then it has this really pretty nice UI and that's taking us through the steps. And the first question is if you want to create a business website or a personal project. Right now I'm gonna create the business website, which is probably the more common use case. The name of the business, I want to create a website for a painting business. And the name of the business right now is Engelhard Painters. All right. And now we have to share some details. This is like the prompt that we know of all the like LLMs and every AI tool. Local painting business that specializes.
A few moments later.
I think we're gonna go with that. Right now, I don't really know how strict the Webflow AI really adheres to the prompt. But all right, let's just continue with this. And then right here we have the brand style. And I think for this, you already have some vision in mind. So I'm gonna go with that and I'll go with the, the sophisticated one, because we want to go with a little bit more sophisticated vibe here and a light theme, more or less. And the brand and voice tone we're gonna keep as AI suggested and the primary color as well. And yeah, that's basically it. That's everything we need to enter. And so let's hit generate. And yeah, we're just gonna wait for a little bit. I have to say, I really like these animations. It's really well done.
One eternity later.
Okay, so this took quite a while, but it seems like it's finished. And let's see. So it looks kind of interesting right now, but my first impression, it is a little bit generic. It's definitely given us a complete site structure with the benefits and like the services, the products, discover more, different plans, which doesn't really make sense for a painting business. I must say it has a testimonial. It's decent, I guess. It has like this this AI feel to it, I'm afraid. Maybe we can just generate it again. Let's see what we can change here, what we can change with the typography. You can make everything bigger or smaller, which is a bit odd, I must say. So if you want to go with something, I think right here, serif would make sense for a painting business. And it has a lot of options for fonts, which are probably like from places like Google fonts and stuff. But yeah, if we go with this, looks quite interesting. I think the buttons are kind of fun, actually. They look, they have like this inner shadow and stuff, which is pretty crazy. And you can also change the colors here. Which doesn't do a lot, I think. I think actually the green was quite okay. And yeah, here you can edit the button styles, which is very cool. You can make them fully rounded. Can make all the buttons monochrome. So yeah, you can make very round buttons. Yeah, there's also this effect, which is kind of cool. But I think for this one, I think actually these ones are quite nice. And you can also edit the input fields so that they also match the styles of the buttons. You can also change the styles of the cards, like to have like more of a, like this effect or a very like subtle one. But yeah, at this point it's definitely not an award-winning site by any stretch of the imagination. And here you can change the roundness of everything, which I find really really practical. So if you want to have everything round, everything cornered, or something in between, like a lot of websites right now go for this like subtle corner style, like this, for example, which is a little bit more sophisticated maybe. I think for this we actually go for that one. The only thing I really don't like right now is the hero. So let's see if we can give it a few more iterations. Okay, it seems like it just changes the copy. Oh, okay, it actually changes the hero. Yeah, I think this is quite interesting. I mean, the layouts are pretty basic, I have to say. The one thing that really surprises me is how easy you can make sideways changes, for example, for the roundness, for all these elements. And yeah, also interesting here that you can change the like the image world, sophisticated. Let's try something else. Let's try something natural light. If it even makes sense with the painting business. And yeah. I think it doesn't really match this color scheme. So let's try something else. Maybe let's go with the earthy one because we have like kind of this earthy green. And yeah, I mean, these are all AI generated images as well, as far as I know. But I think they look quite all right at the moment. Yeah, let's change this section here too. I don't really like it that much. Oh, this is quite nice, like this overlapping card effect. I think it looks quite good. And now once you're kind of like satisfied with your initial generated build, you can anyway hit start building here at the bottom. And then it will take you into the just a regular Webflow editor that you know. And you can basically tweak all that you want. So you have full control, unlike in some other AI website builders, which is already way superior, I think. You can make a full Webflow build out of this. Maybe the AI generated website could be a good starting point, I imagine. I think this card effect is really nice. This is really surprising me right now. But other than that, it's actually quite basic, I must say. Yeah, this navigation is quite nice. I like it quite a lot. And yeah, again, with the button styles, it doesn't look so bad. And now let's see if it's also already responsive. So if we make it smaller with the tablet breaking point, which is a little bit weird because yeah, you just start with the images and then below is the text, which doesn't really work, I think. If we go to mobile, we have this weird thing there at the top. And also the text starts below the fold, which is usually not a good practice in web design, but it could be easily fixed. So now AI generated a lot of sections, but what if we need more sections and we also want them to be generated? So let's say, for example, a painting business probably needs a gallery section. So we're gonna hit here to section and create something new. And it will analyze the site style. And so we can maybe add a gallery section right here. And it lets us pick one. Let's go for this. Okay, so that's not bad at all, I guess. Let's see if these tabs actually work. Very nice. Paint and finishes. Oh, wow, it actually made a before and after image. That doesn't make a lot of sense, but the idea is there. Well, anyway, as a painter, you should probably put in your own images here instead of AI-generated ones. But it's a great starting point. And so that's pretty nice that you can add and regenerate more sections here if you need them. If you go here to the theme, you can do all the changes that we made before here also. But also you have the site variables. So if you go here into the base collection, anyway, there is the whole design system. So if you want to change the colors, if you want to change anything, you can change it all here and it will be changed site-wide. So for example, also the radius. Yeah, it's a lot, man. I think the AI, it really, it generates a lot of stuff that maybe you don't even need. It's great that it's there and it's fully customizable. So, okay, so let's try one more thing. We're gonna try to add one more page to this AI generated site and let's try to add a contact page. Gonna hit here into this panel, create a new page and gonna create a new, like generate new page with AI. And it has these predefined categories and we're gonna pick contact and it's not even asking us for any layout or anything. So let's just see what happens. Okay, so I imagine this is the contact page right now. It has like this little interaction, which is quite nice. And then down here, it has this contact information. Again, the gallery, I don't really know if that makes sense. And then it has this call to action, which doesn't look so bad. And then if we click contact us, it doesn't do anything. So this is not like linked with anything. So it would have been nice if there was like a contact form. So let's just try to add it maybe down here. Let's see if we can add a contact form. And yeah, apparently it only has like this predefined where there's like the contact information, but no contact form. I don't know, maybe this will be added later. It's only the beta after all. And so yeah, what if you wanted to change the font site-wide? That's actually pretty easy because it's already well built. We just go into the variables and the base collection. And then we scroll down here until we are at the font section. And then here for the heading font, we can pick something else. Right in here, it doesn't have a big selection, but you can anyway upload your own font and use that. So you basically have unlimited control. I'm going to just pick Oswald here. And for the body font, we're going to pick, let's go for this one. It doesn't really matter anyway. And it's instantly changed, of course. And yeah, it gives you a lot of control. Also, you can go here into the style guide and there's all the style guides generated already. And I think it looks quite decent, I must say. It's quite shocking, actually, how good this has become. I mean, these links don't really work, but it is what it is. So, I started this video quite skeptical if this would just be another AI letdown. But after building this painting business website in just under 10 minutes, I have to say, I'm quite amazed at how powerful this tool really is. The site looks quite clean, professional, and honestly, it even looks better than some templates that I've seen so far. It's responsive, the design system is cohesive, and it doesn't even have this generic AI feeling I was expecting in some parts. That said, you can definitely see where a good designer's touch is absolutely still necessary. Those finishing touches that take a site from good to great. Things like fine-tuning the visual hierarchy, adding custom animations and micro-interactions, creating truly unique section layouts, and one of the biggest, injecting genuine brand personality. These are all areas where a skilled designer still adds enormous value. The AI gives you a solid 80% solution, but that last 20% is where the real magic happens. For small business owners who just need a professional website presence, who don't have a big budget for a custom design, this could be really effective. You can now build something in an afternoon that would previously maybe have taken weeks and thousands of dollars. For professional designers and agencies, this could be a powerful starting point that could eliminate a lot of the setup work. Instead of wasting time building the basic structure, you can jump straight into the creative and strategic work that actually justifies your expertise. I have to say, I'm quite impressed with what Webflow accomplished here. It's not in any way perfect. You'll see moments in the walkthrough where some things didn't quite work as expected, but that's normal for a first version. And it's still in beta after all. So what do you think about it? And if you found this video interesting, consider subscribing and I'll see you in the next one.